Spirit. In the name of Jesus we pray, Amen. Those who are watching over the internet, good morning, hello, and good evening. In our church, we give 1/10 of the income for the works outside of the church. We pray for those 78,000 yen. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for giving us blessings. Spiritual as well as financial blessings. As a token of thanksgiving, we give you this money and use it for the advancement of your kingdom and the appearance of your glory. And thank you for your blessing. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Good morning, everyone, again. We have a short movie of the Kokoro Gospel concert we held some days ago, a week ago. So let's take a look.
ただ温度が下がってやっぱり出なくなるんですね。Thank you very much. For the TNCCC, praise and worship is very important meaning. There are two purposes. One is being filled by the Lord. We worship the Lord in praise and worship. And another thing is that non-Christians will be touched by God through the gospel, so that they will be healed and will receive blessings. And God tells us that it is the foundation of the revival. So please pray. are seeing this kind of work in the Christian, Christian church in Japan. We'd like to thank the Lord. And I think it's going to be advanced. And many various kinds of things are going to happen, so expect what God does. And through music, God pours out the Holy Spirit upon us. And special work is going to happen. We have a video of Israel team, so let's take a look.
はい、どうもありがとうございました。
Now we are using the movies and videos, and it will be a very powerful weapon for the overseas mission work. And we are seeking it, and we are improving. But I would like to make a movie as good as the world.Movies, videos, and praise and worship, praise and worship has much to do with each other. And before I became a Christian, And the reason why is that God is working in us. We don't have the talent for food. We don't have to And this world team will be held. Anyone can join us. In November is the God told us that to start the new year from Israel as an Israelite. That's what God told us. And it's hard to interpret this, but there are two kinds of Israelites. A spiritual Israel, that is a Christian, and a tribal Israel. A spiritual Israel is Israelite.So, as a being of heaven, and from Israel, Israel is a symbol of God's kingdom. So, through God's kingdom, be sent out in the beginning of the year.Your life is eternal. As a result of development of the movie techniques, we can see the service over the internet. We can watch that from Israel. So those who go to Israel and those who stay through online worship, we can worship together and we can start a new year. And as a being of the God's heavenlyJerusalem, I think we'd like to be sent out for this year, for the coming next year. We have a video of a Cambodia orphanage, so let's take a look.
写真もう一度見たくても
When I first read about the orphanage, Christian orphanage, was in the book by George Miller. He showed great blessings of God, and I was moved, and I thought I really wanted to do the will of God. I mean the work of the orphanage. But I was praying so that I would be able to do the works of the orphanage. And we thank God because God opened the door and gave us
a
And orphanage, when the orphanage, number of orphanage people will increase. And in the work of the Christian Center, we lose Christianity. And there is a width and the height of those works. So let's take a look with expectation.
皆さんこんにちは。今日のテーマはロシアがイスラエルを攻める時です。エゼキエル書38章に獄マゴクがイスラエルを攻めるという予言が書かれています。獄マゴクとは北の果てのあなたの国とあるようにイスラエルから見て北の果てのロシアを表します。またペルシャとクシュとプテも彼らと共におりとあります。ペルシャは今のイラン、クシュはエチオピア、プテはリビアのことで、ロシアはイラン、エチオピア、リビア、その他の同盟国を引き連れてイスラエルを攻めるのです。ロシアがイスラエルを攻める時期についてエゼキエル書38章8節を見ていきましょう。この予言はイスラエルとイスラエルの民に対する予言ですが、多くの国々にイスラエル人が散らされまた集められるという予告を含みます。その予告通り AD130 年頃ローマ帝国によってイスラエル人は散らされイスラエルは廃墟となりますが、20世紀に入って世界に散らされたイスラエル人は帰ってきます。そしてイスラエル国として1948年に独立しました。さて彼らは皆安心して住んでいるという言葉がロシアがイスラエルを攻める時を示しています。これは中東和平が締結した後のイスラエルを表していると思われます。中東和平は観覧時代の初めに締結されますから、この戦争は観覧時代に起こることが分かります。黙示録6章8節第4の封印に出てくる剣とは大きな戦争を指していますが、これがロシアと同盟軍によるイスラエルの戦いを見していると思われます。イスラエルだけを攻める局地的な戦争ではなく、ロシアやイラン本土などを含む大きな戦争になると思われます。核兵器も使われると思われ、凄まじい数の死者が出るでしょう。ロシアがイスラエルを攻める理由はエゼキエル書38章12節にあるように経済的理由と思われます。さらに38章4節を見ると、自分から積極的に出ていくというのではなく、経済的に追い詰められ出ざるを得ない状況となり攻めるようになるのでしょう。しかしこの戦争では地震が大きな役割を果たします。結局この地震がきっかけとなり、ロシア軍と同盟軍は混乱し同士討ちをするようになり敗れるのです。この地震は第6の封印の地震と思われ、裁きと関わる重要な意味を持っています。私たちはこれからのロシアの動きを注意深く見ていく必要があります。それではまた。
はい、どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. Russia is going to make war. It's in the termination period and it's approaching. In the first half, Russia makes war.And it's going to be a big war. If you look at Israel and the countries around him, you can see the work of the Lord advancing. And what we need to see those kinds of things, the rapture is in the center of the 7 years.
ゲス様の来られる町の上とか
example, when you are looking forward to the second coming of Christ, and you are waiting for and God is trying to do something through us. So let's go into the Bible. Today, we speak about the Satan's work. Thank you for your prayer. So that we can go to Kyushu and we'll be able to come back from here. And various kinds of songs are being sent to us, including the Enka songs. Music is directly connected with the works of the spiritual works. And also, last week, we asked you how many of you have seen the evil spirits. I'm not saying that seeing evil spirit is good. And I also asked how many of you have seen an angel. But it was less than the cases when angel appears, but we don't realize that, and we interact. person, but the person was actually an angel. I prayed, God, have I...
チベットに行った時、ウタラキュっていうところがあるんですね。ウタラキュね。ウタラキュってのは、かつてダライラマが住んでいて、城ですけどね。
It's a castle in Tibet. We went to Buddha Palace for spiritual battle. But it was a holiday for the Buddha palace. But we walked outside, and there came a Chinese car, and they stopped the car, and the high officer of China came out. And the high officer can go into. Forced us to come into the palace with them, and we were forced to go into probably that were, those were the only two groups which were able to go into the palace. And that person explained to the Chinese officer, and we listened to the explanation, and immediately we bound the spirit. Now let's go into the Bible. Satan is working among you. It's working. working on you. He's trying to keep you away from God and keep you from believing God. For example, we are loved by God. Nobody is loved by God more than us. Last week, husband of Pastor Otto's sister passed away. Disbelief. Another is Satan's work. All of our sins are forgiven. Whatever. So we are already blessed. Sister, 30 years ago, God gave her a word that I'm going to send you to Israel. And I thought that she has a calling for the works of Israel. And she was relying on the word, but for 10 years nothing happened. Nothing happened. She said, that came to me and she said, I'm going to go to the church which really performs the work of Israelite missionary works. So I said, you are going to quit now, and you will lose your calling if you do that. And I'm going to use your example. I use your story as an example of a person who lost their calling. Two sisters were ordained. So Israelites, I have a strong connection with Abbasi Church. At the first early days of our church, out of 20, 18 was from Abbasi Church. I was in a seminary school, certain denomination. I spoke with Pastor Rai. And it was decided that I go to Mabashi as a pastor. And God told me that Mabashi Church is my church, obey my guidance, he said.
そういう言い方。 ただね、ここにいろっていう。ね。だからね、そこにいまして。ぐるっとね、すぐ乗れると。そしたらね、不思議なことがあった。誰もなかった。普通、大教会の動きっていうのはね、中学生が子供の立場なんで、給料高いし、仕事少ないし、いろんなことできるし。それでね、結局どうなったのかというとね、あの、教会ってのは死ぬものですね、役に立たないひっくり返したことがあって、死ぬことがあった。結局ね、誰も来なかったので、一年間にということで、伝道師として、説教させないという要件で、私の話を受けて、そして一年後に家庭に帰りました。それを私の目の前で、会心の前に行ってましたね。まあ、でもね、それも感謝した。感謝してるか、あれ、それまではですね、いやいや、笑いながら聞いてやりました。でも、そこにいるっていうのが、具体的に。ところがね、おかしなことがあったんですね。1年間私に説教させないということだったら、4月にあれてたら、本心と説教者が来なかったら誰もいるのか。だから1年間私は説教しないということでしたが、私は4月から説教した。だから神の手を止められないんですね。そしてね、そこでね、私はね、復讐の祈りになったんですね。でどういうふうに復讐の祈りをしたかというとね、この役人の中心の方々は、私が神から使わされたものだということを知らない。だから私が神から使わされたものであることを明確に示している。こういうのだったんですね。で、自分の内容はね、12月の末までに私を取って50日とそしたら人が救われ始めて、もう5月、6月にですね、
62 persons were saved through me.And Satan is trying to take that away from you. So stand firmly in the word of God. Standing on the word of God firmly is very important. I'm going to pray. Lord, please lead and guide this time.Somebody doesn't have confidence because he's looking at the wrong direction.
その時に明確に神様を教えてくださり、理解をするところに、特別な信仰の資格を持たす。どういうふうに気にさえどういうことにならないでしょうか。なんか焦って何かやらなければならないと思っているのかもしれませんが、神の言葉を待ち、神の言葉に従って対応していきましょう。癒しの祈りをした
い。I'm going to pray for the sick. Let's have a time of repentance.Please pray for your own healing. Dear Heavenly Father, please touch each one of us, our body and mind. In the name of Jesus, you spirit of disease be gone from us. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Each one's body be healed. Healed. Somebody has somebody's left eye has been healed. Somebody's shoulder is aching and it's been healed.
聖霊の親しき交わりが私たち人と共に常しえにあります。アメン。